ceremony of the Lieutenant General Michael A. Hill, Commander of the 8th United States Army and Chief of Staff of the Combined Forces Command. Lieutenant General Michael A. Hill has been earned honor to the Brigadier General from Mobile Vietnam Expo. During today's ceremony, when attention to order is announced, please remain seated to observe the ceremony. Before we begin today's ceremony, we would like to recognize a few distinguished attendees in the audience. Dr. Alton Gordon, Director of NCOM, Major General Baker, Commanding General of NCOM, Scholar Hall, Google Foundation, Mr. Kim Inju, Mr. Kim Nong-su from Samsung, Mr. Kim Bijin, Chairman of General Walker Memorial Foundation, Brigadier General Lee Song-ki, representing Combined Forces Command, Mr. Park Hong-yu, Chairman of Korean American Friendship Association. We are pleased to extend a special welcome to General Wong's wife, Mrs. Kim Wong, their daughter, Ashley, and son, Brandon, and Justin Wong. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the arrival of our official party and remain standing for the flag of the Republic of Korea and the United States of America National Anthem.
Everyone, including me, to review this tradition. Heavenly Father, we are grateful for your presence here today during Women and Rogan X Blog's promotion ceremony. Promotion comes not in a vacuum, but first from above. Having gathered with a wonderful family and a willing leadership who helps each step of the way, you have blessed Mrs. and General One and their children, their family who are truly servants, actively involved in our community and spiritual disciplines. As this ceremony comes to a close, may you continue to cultivate in them a heart of humility, whereby their actions speak louder than words. Help General One never lose sight of servant leadership, emulating God's godly character, and embodying army values. May your presence go with them, your peace in them, and your protection over them as they continue to serve God and country. Lord, we have a petition to make. Bless and protect all the soldiers, our sons and daughters in harm's way, and put them under your mighty wing. In your holy and precious name we pray. Amen.
A bouquet of flowers is now being presented to Mrs. Kim Wong, along with mementos to his daughter Ashley and son Brandon and Justin, to show General Wong's appreciation for a lifetime of support. It is my pleasure to introduce host for today's ceremony, Lieutenant General Michael A. Mills.
Kukung Kyokung Viet Hong. That is, congratulations to Major General Viet Hong in Vietnamese. Ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, soldiers of H Army, welcome. Thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedules in order to celebrate this extremely significant milestone in Major General Viet Long's career. It gives you no greater pleasure than to preside over Viet's promotion today. Viet is not only an outstanding leader, but he is someone I consider a true friend. He and I served together in 1st Cavalry Division, and now together in 8th Army, and he is one of my most trusted advisors because he holds himself and those around him to an impeccable standard. He inspires his staff to reach their full potential, and he has made a substantial impact here at 8th Army. Like all great leaders, he has not accomplished any of this alone. He has a tremendous support network, his wife Kim, who has been by his side for 25 years, and their three children, Ashley, 22, who is home this summer, a break from Louis Mary, also Brandon, 19, who just completed his junior year at UVA, pursuing a degree in public policy, and Justin, 17, who just recently graduated from Humphreys High School. In addition, I'd like to recognize those of you joining us through Facebook Live, Viet's seven sisters and their families, as well as all the extended family watching. I would like to extend a special thank you to all the Vietnam veterans in that group. Thank you for your service. Please, a round of applause. Viet, like his children, grew up in a military family. The Viet father was a major in the Vietnamese Marine Corps who fought in the Vietnam War. I'm sure he is with us today, in spirit, absolutely bursting with pride, despite his decision to join the Army. Viet's family and his childhood played a major role in shaping the outstanding leader he is today. In 1975, he was 9 when he and his seven sisters fled Vietnam, just one day before Saigon fell. The U.S. Marine helicopter flew Vietnamese family to safety aboard the USS Hancock, the United States aircraft carrier. Standing on the deck as a young refugee, he decided one day to serve the United States. This story only happens in a place like the United States of America. He is an American by choice, not by birth. His commitment to upholding your democracy and his hard work and diligence have propelled him to the top ranks of our army. I'd like to take a moment to talk about Viet and what makes him a true patriot. The word patriot signifies a person who loves his or her country and is ready to boldly support and defend it. There is no one who epitomizes the word patriot or what it takes to be a soldier in more than Vietnam. His impressive career spans 30 years, multiple combat deployments, command of the 3rd BCP in Pakistan's 101st Airborne in Afghanistan, Deputy Commanding General of the storied 1st Cavalry Division, U.S. RCS Chief of Staff, and most recently, Deputy Commanding General of Operations Green Army. He's also a devoted brother, husband, and father, who is committed to his family. All said, Major General Caleb Wong is an American success story as he and his wife, Kim, who's also a refugee from Vietnam, represents the American dream for every immigrant and that anyone can be successful in the United States as long as you work hard, live a life of values and integrity, and pursue education. As Viet demonstrates through his daily example, no one is going to hand you the American dream you have to earn. Viet, we are lucky to have the leader of your caliber in our organization. You have enhanced our operations, mentored our soldiers, and strengthened the alliance. You are not only an inspiration to everyone you touch, but you are the premier example of the Army getting talent management right. I can think of no other officer in our Army who is more deserving of this promotion. Kachi Kachina, Pacific Vintage.
We welcome General Wong's family to assist in today's promotion ceremony.
Attention orders. The President of the United States has reposed special trust and confidence in the patriotism, valor, fidelity, and abilities of Brigadier General Promotable Viet Wong. In view of these qualities and his demonstrated potential for increased responsibility, he is therefore promoted to Major General with a date of rank of 02 August 2017 by order of the Secretary of the Army.
Lieutenant General Bills will now administer the oath of office to Major General Wong.
I state your name.
I, Your Excellency.
Having been appointed an officer in the Army of the United States.
Having been appointed an officer in the Army of the United States.
In the rank of Major General.
The rank of Major General.
You solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies.
Foreign and domestic.
Foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I take this obligation freely.
Take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservations or purpose of evasion.
Without any mental reservations or purpose of evasion.
And that I will well and faithfully discharge.
That I will well and faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office upon which I am about to enter.
The duties of the office upon which I am about to enter.
So I'm
here. So help me God.
Distinguished guests, friends, family, thank you for taking the time to be here this afternoon. I'm honored by your presence. This is a special day for me and certainly an incredible honor. I stand before you with humility and respect. This promotion is much more profound than the journey of a man with a very humble background, but is in as much about the character of our nation. Too often, we speak about promotions in terms of talent, hard work, luck, and timing. However, we don't often talk about what a privilege it is to live in the land of free and the wondrous privileges we enjoy as Americans. I'm American by choice, and I've chosen to serve our country to help preserve our freedom and way of life. Like many Vietnamese American immigrants before me, we have joined despite coming from a war-torn country. My friend, Jackie Lee, I think he's somewhere in the back, retired CW2, and he's a GS-13 with G-32. And my cousin, Chao Lei, with only green cards in hand and immense dreams, they enlisted in the U.S. Army. They did not ask to go to just any unit, they went to the 82nd Airborne Division. So all three of us ended up at Fort Bragg in the mid-90s, serving in three different battalions. We were lucky. 13 Vietnamese Americans have made the ultimate sacrifice in Iraq and Afghanistan, and scores wounded in action. We did not come here to fight. We served. We didn't come here to die. However, we are passionate about freedom, and we're willing to put our lives on the line to preserve that. I have many people to thank today, but I want to first and foremost give thanks to the nation that has embraced my family and given us the opportunities to succeed. I also want to recognize Lieutenant General Mike Mills for presiding over this ceremony. Served you in a mentor and an advocate for me for many years, and I know I will not be standing here today without you. And Kim and I are blessed to be joining you immediately this second time around. As I told you, you are not first cabin, anywhere, any place, anytime. I'm here for you. 8th Army is very lucky to have you as our commanding general. To my brother, Scott McKean, he's trying to make his way down here, and he's in route. Mike Russell, Arlen Levine, Ken Taylor. Hey, I'm just proud to be in the same families with you. And I want to thank you for watching my planks over the last year. I also want to pay special tribute to the soldiers and NCOs with whom I have served. Some are not here because they have given their lives in the defense of this nation. For me, their loss has been up close and very personal. I think of them and their families every day. I would have traded every accolade, every recognition, every promotion to have them back on this earth.
But I know it's not possible. So every day that I live, and with every promotion in my career, I try to be the best leader that I can. I'm lucky enough to have with me here some of the great NCOs and officers that I've had the privilege of serving with in combat. From the 82nd Airborne Division, John Reed, CW2 Raymond Jones, Sergeant Major McGee, 1st Sergeant TJ Davenport, Master Sergeant Bob Porter-Magby, from the 101st Airborne Division, Major Dustin Randall, 1st Sergeant Mick Carrillo, and from the 1st Path Division, Captain Michael McConnell, CW2 David Textera. Thank you for being here today. And my only hope is, despite my shortcomings, that I have lived up to your expectations as a leader. Please accept my sincere gratitude. A huge debt of gratitude goes to my parents. I lost my dad in 1997 and my mom just this past January. Many of you are aware of my personal story. My sister and I would not be where we are without our parents' love, nurture, and sacrifice. They toiled to their very last days to enable our success. And from my mom, I inherited the virtues of selfless sacrifice, hard work, perseverance, and unconditional love for one's family. My dad is my hero. He inculcated in me the virtues of duty, honor, and country. In 1968, during the height of the Tet Offensive, my family was caught in the middle of a raging conflict. As the enemy shells rained on us and our house consumed in acrid smoke, my mom pushed us out into the hellish streets of Saigon. We had to fend for ourselves. My dad never came for us, but instead, he stayed and fought with his company, as any good Marine infantry officer would have. In 97, my dad was dying of cancer. I was in the field when my unit received an emergency phone call from my oldest sister, and she told me, "You need to get home now, your dad's on the last 24 hours." I immediately came into the field and called my dad. He knew at that time, because we used to talk every week, that I was preparing a cab unit to deploy to Boston. Precisely Ross Coughlin's troop, now B.G. Coughlin, to go to Boston. And when I told him I was coming home early, he protested and told me I need to stay where I am to fulfill my duties, because that's what good leaders do. The next day, he passed. I have many regrets in my life, perhaps that's one of the biggest. But I know if he were here today, he would be proud to see me here for real, still doing my duty to the best of my abilities. To my sisters out there watching on Facebook there, and my brothers-in-law, thank you for decades of love and support. Several of my older sisters can sacrifice so much so that the younger siblings can succeed. And with my parents continuously working, they are surrogate parents, mentors, and teachers. And I know there's no fairness in the culture that embraces primogeniture. So I want to salute you for handling the bias with unparalleled grace, love, and support. Another group I want to recognize out there are the Vietnam veterans, both U.S. and Republic of Vietnam, very near and dear to my heart. Scores of them are watching right now. Several of my uncles are among the group out there. Two of my uncles and one of Kim's uncles were officers in the Vietnamese Army, and they served each for more than a dozen years in prison camps. And although their bodies were crushed, their valiant spirit remained. Through them, I learned that liberty and freedom is above life itself. And I want to tell them, that do that now, now they do. Set judge, I salute you for your service and sacrifice. You honor me with your presence. To our Korean friends who are here today, many have traveled a long way. Chasu Keju, Joso, Gamsamina. Among our honored guests, scholar Ha
Ah Yun-sung, Chairman Kim In-joo and Kim Nam-soo of Samsung and their lovely spouses have traveled a long way from Seoul. We also have Chairman Park Hong-gil, who's a very dear friend, Chairman of CAFA, and Chairman Kim Ri-jin from the Walker Foundation. I also want to highlight that Chairman Kim is a Korean War vet, and he also earned the U.S. Bronze Star for Valor at Joseon. And we also have two neighbors, Chairman Jin Jong-young, Chairman Cho Ken-tuk, and Ms. Cho Cho-jin. Thank you for your friendship. As a Vietnamese Marine officer, my dad fought side by side with the ROK Marines during the Vietnam War. He often spoke highly of their gallantry and professionalism in combat. His legacy is my connection to Korea and its people. Jeremy Garber was right when he said, quote, "The magnificence of the courage and fortitude of the Korean people defies description," end quote. I am now witnessing that firsthand, and although this is my first assignment in Korea, I feel an unexplainable link to this country and its wonderful people. I truly feel like I'm home now. So in my current role, I hope to be able to assist and contribute to peace and prosperity on our peninsula. Finally, to my Yim family, this has been a long journey for the Long family. Ashley and Brandon, three high schools in 3 years. Justin, four high schools in 4 years. And I know I was gone for several of those years. Despite the challenges, all three are scholars and athletes. I'm proud of all three of you and the wonderful adults you have become. I love you unconditionally. But with that said, you know me well. All SOPs and procedures. You know you've had a much better start than your mom and I had, so I will continue to demand the very best from you. Getting a B is still like an F. And you must win at everything you need to do. Your future is bright and the opportunities are endless. Carpe diem. And finally, to my dear wife, Kim. The Vietnamese poetic line of Tu Cha Tet No, Gun Zha Tech Maha Mu Chen Chu, best encapsulates your experience as a spouse. Our journey has been long, at times fraught with challenges, but our love remains strong. All the great things that my children have done are attributable to Kim. She's been the spark major of the Luang clan. The strength of my family really rests with her. Of course, I knew that when I married her in 1993. We were on our honeymoon when we were directed to report to the 82nd Airborne early. So we cut the celebration short and I reported to Fort Bragg. I dropped her off at temporary lodging 2 days later. I was in Panama. And back in those days, before commercial internet and cell phones, communication was impossible. When I finally got home 45 days later, Kim had rented a place and moved all her belongings into our house by herself. And shortly after my company command time at Fort Bragg, I was selected to command for a second time the 18th Airborne Corps Long Range Reconnaissance Company. I was preparing to take my second command when I received orders for the Joint Readiness Training Center. The Army informed the 18th Airborne Corps that I had too much time at Fort Bragg and too much command time, so I had to move. The Corps DCG fought HRC, but lost. So in the end, I was directed to move my family to Fort Polk in 2 weeks. Kim and I packed up 1 year after. We moved out as directed. And I remember as I was driving to the outskirts of Fort Polk, Kim began crying. Not a word was said then. And in the next 2 years at Fort Polk, not a single complaint or cry. Several years later, and 2 kids later, I was in command of the 2nd Battalion 505th Parachute Infantry. We were deployed to a very evil place called Samarra in Iraq after they just blew up the Golden Mosque and propagated a series of sectarian violence all throughout the theater. In our 15-month deployment, my battalion led hard. Some of you who are here, Andy, that important. Indeed, you saw it firsthand. Many good men died and were permanently maimed, while others became heroes. We left Iraq, the most decorated battalion of the war, with two troopers, receiving the Distinguished Service Cross and 7 Silver Stars, scores of Bronze Stars for battle. Despite the ensuing accolades, there was no celebration for us. We licked our wounds and we mourned our fallen. Many of us vowed that we would return tomorrow to finish the fight. On the home front, the situation was more dire than I thought. Kim had been at the center of every visit, at every hospital, every memorial, every comfort prayer, every meal on wheels for those of our families. After 15 months, she was done. When I returned to Fort Bragg, I remember her telling me, "I'm unsure how much longer I will be able to go on as a command spouse." We both decided that it was time for us to retire because we'd done our nation's deeds. Then fate took a turn. Before I had enough time to retire, and unbeknownst to me, I was selected for colonel. And 3 months later, I received a call. General Rodriguez was in Afghanistan, congratulating me for being selected to command the storied Pakistan, 3rd Brigade of the 101st. After much thought, I approached Kim and asked for her support. I was told that the Pakistan were heading to combat in Afghanistan. And I remember telling Kim, "Let me do it just one more time." Because I thought I had the skills and the leadership to keep our boys alive. Kim said nothing. But in my heart, I knew that was her way of telling me that she would fully support what I wanted to do, as she had done over 25 years of marriage. Now, Kim had those 6 assignments to her. She's still here by my side, my stalwart pillow of support. And Kim, I want to tell you that I'm blessed to have you as my wife, and more importantly, I'm blessed to have you as the mother of our children. I look forward to spending many more years ahead with you. Lastly, I want to thank all of us who have worked so hard to put this together. Monica, you're a superstar. Major Lou Choi, Master Sergeant Stride, carry a heavy load with this, Staff Sergeant Herman, thank you. And my personal staff, Dave, Mason, Kim Yu Rin, Choi Sung Lam. And I'm not sure if you recognize that our flag bearer today was not a U.S. soldier, but he was a Rock Harbor Katusa soldier, Corporal Choi Sung Lam. And I have asked him to participate in the ceremony because he's one of the best soldiers we had in our headquarters. So, and 8th Army Band up on top, thank you. You are the best always. Again, thank you for attending. Kamsahamnida, Pacific Victors, Kachikasida.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the playing of the 8th Army Song and the Army Song.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending today's ceremony. You are cordially invited to attend the reception held on the second floor. Please follow the stairwell upward to congratulate Major General Wong and his family.
Thank you.